run it up, run it up, run it up. Nothing can stop me. Run it up, run it up, run it up, run it up, run it up. Nothing can stop me.
I'm alive in the dark, and I keep getting stronger. My limit's the sky.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to Las Vegas, Nevada. Today, we've got a Week 13 matchup for you here between the Los Angeles Chargers and the Las Vegas Raiders. The calendar has turned to December, and we're in the home stretch now as we're underway in Week 13. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Started on the ground with Eckler. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. Carry to set them up with a second and three.
32-yard line. It's a gain of seven. Brings up second and three.
Once more, here's Eckler. Now he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that's going to lead to a third and four coming up.
That's a play to take note of there for the defense. I think in the future, if you're going to try and block him, maybe you get a guard to help double team him and try and steer him out of the play. They should have done it on that snap.
To avoid an early three and out here on third and four. Herbert just beat the play clock. That's caught by his tight end, Gerald Everett. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. And 21 yards there as they convert on third.
When you get a big tight end like this, sometimes it takes more than one man to bring him down. Oftentimes, your best bet, just jump on and hold on and wait for your teammates to arrive to help get him on the ground.
So here's a first and 10 now in Raider territory at the 48-yard line. Running on first down, Eckler. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here. Second down.
And Charles, you think about what this defense has had to prepare for. They're in for a battle. I mean, they're facing a team that is working on a six-game winning streak.
And that can be intimidating when you think about it in those terms, but I think what they need to do is make some sort of a statement early in this game, whether it's a turnover, a takeaway, a key sack on third down, a three and out. Something lets the other guys know that you mean business. Figuratively, throw the first punch and make it a good one.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and eight. Now with just 1 second showing on the play clock, we're going to get a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Second and eight coming up. It's Eckler again. And he's going to be met at about the 43. Well, this defense for the Raiders, they were terrific a week ago in the win over Seattle.
Yeah, what stood out to me on tape, the way they were flying to the football. So that tells me that they've got all their assignments down and they're playing with extreme confidence.
And the Raiders call on a nickel set for third down. A shotgun snap for Herbert. Looking for Jones, and it's intercepted. And the Raiders are going to take possession of the football as they force the turnover on the opening drive. Well, that is a quick lesson on how difficult this defense is to throw against an interception on their initial drive of the ball game.
Now we know why their offensive staff spent the entire week awake trying to prepare for this one, because you can't totally shy away from throwing the football. But at the same time, you're looking at them and going, where are the weaknesses? How are we going to move it?
One of the top defenses in the NFL for a reason. We just saw one example right there. And now the Chargers are going to signal for another timeout. And that's their second charge timeout here in this first quarter. They're down to one remaining. A good starting spot for the Raiders as they come up first and 10 at their own 42. After the interception, here's Jackson. They swing that out wide to Jacobs. On the move past the 40, down the right sideline, and he's going to be pushed out of bounds inside the 10-yard line. A big play there on the catch and run, 51 yards. The offense has to love that, because that was just a dump down, and then he turned something out of seemingly nothing.
And the best quarterbacks understand that dumping it down is often a good play, a better play than even what was drawn up.
Here's Jacobs, and they'll be driven back here, losing yardage to the 10-yard line. It's a loss of four there, bringing up second down.
This defense is a difficult one to prepare for, one of the best in the league. They'll come at you from all angles, and they did a nice job there stopping him for a loss.
Moved back to the 10, they'll try on second and goal here. Jackson from the shotgun. And a quick throw here, that's complete. That time the completion goes for 4 yards, and we're set up with a third and goal.
In today's football, where receivers break tackles, make people miss, get upfield for the extra yardage, when you see a play like that where it's caught and he's dropped on the spot, that's a big time play by the defense.
A big play forthcoming. Here's third and goal. To throw is Jackson. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
Sometimes the game is pretty simple. Put a few extra defensive backs on the field, give them nowhere to throw the football, force the incompletion, and get off the field on third down.
Fourth down, and on comes the Raider kicker, Daniel Carlson. This is an easy one, 23-yarder. The kick by Carlson is good, and the Raiders jump out to a 3-0 advantage. So an opening drive field goal maybe doesn't whip this crowd into a frenzy, but I think that they will take the early lead.
There's no doubt about it. They will always take the early lead, and maybe that celebration comes later if they play well and they can break things open. But right now, this is all about letting the offense just get settled in.
After the made field goal, Carlson now sets up to kick this away. And it'll come out to the 25 as he will not attempt to return. The Charger drive about to get going. Their second drive here, the ball game, Charles. Remember last time they threw the interception, but the defense held up. It bent a little but didn't break, only giving up the 3 points.
Yeah, obviously they left some points on the table there their last time out, but boy, they have to thank their defense for holding the opposition just 3 after they threw the pick. Their turn now, back out on the field, putting together a good drive and get some points of their own. Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play? It was only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
On 2nd and 7, Herbert. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
Part of what we're seeing so far is the defense is certainly coordinated. Both levels doing their jobs in tandem. The back helping the front helping the back. The pressure got home on that last play and forced him to try and throw through contact and short of the sticks.
They head to the line facing a 3rd and 7 following the incompletion on 2nd down. Here's Herbert. And the Raiders have got him. Max Crosby, he's the one to get him, and that is sack number 7 for him on the year. On 4th down, J.K. Scott ready to punt it away. He was only asked to punt once in the victory last week as he sends this one away. This is brought in at the 21. That'll be put in the books as a 53-yard punt. And it'll be Raiders football, 1st and 10. The Raider offense set to get this drive started. They've got a 3-0 lead and the football as they start 1st and 10. They'll begin on the ground with Jacobs. And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple, and that's it. He's taken down at the 33-yard line. 2 yards. 3-0 after 1 on EA Sports. Second and 8. Now it's Jackson. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Derwin James with a pick, and the Chargers are going to take possession of the football.
And Brandon, this is a real nice job defensively of getting inside a quarterback's head and figuring out, okay, where is he going with the football? because you can make an educated guess defensively. Not all the time, but sometimes. And when you're right, you've got a decent chance of coming away with the football.
And the running lane's non-existent in this first half as they'll stop him behind the line.
I have a feeling they'll stay committed to running the football, especially on the early downs. They just haven't had a whole lot of success just yet.
Second and 12. Herbert looking downfield for Jones. And that will be incomplete. Trying to dial up the long way out there, but it'll be third down.
There is something to a game plan with trying to keep a defense honest with a guy with that type of speed. You do so. Send him deep. Try to throw some air under it and hope you connect downfield. On that play, they run successful.
This offense on third down today, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is third down and 12. Play action. It's Herbert. Incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Oh, that's going to hurt a bit because they needed to come through the completion there. Now a drive that started with great field position is facing fourth down.
Here's J.K. Scott set to do the punting honors. And that ball's going to angle out at the 3-yard line. A beauty.
That is how you flip field position. That's an absolute bomb of a punt. Downs it inside the 5-yard line. Absolutely ideal.
From that position, you're hoping to get it down inside the 15, inside the 5. Superb.
The offense for Las Vegas about set to begin the drive.
And we'll see if they can bounce back from that last drive. In particular, if they can bounce back at the quarterback position, Charles, after throwing their first interception of the ball game.
Yeah, some guys, you know, they're going to want to try and get a big play right away and take control back. Others, they're going to look at a couple shorter passes, get a little momentum back that way.
But for the defense, that goal is not changing a bit. They want another pick.
You're exactly right about that. In fact, you've got to watch them a little bit because in coverage, they may cut down their gaps a little bit, maybe their splits a little bit in order to try and get to the ball even faster.
His first catch there, good for 10 yards and a first down.
The Raiders at 8-3 now. They've certainly found their groove of late, winners of 5 in a row.
And this team is absolutely playing their best football right now. This is the best that we've seen them play in a long time, partner. Sky's the limit as far as they're concerned. Their confidence really soaring.
They go play action with Jackson. Flushed out right. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Now these two teams, they met up way back in the season opener. And it was the visitors getting the win there, so they'll be looking for the sweep back here at home.
Again from the 20 after the incompletion. Here's 2nd and 10. Here's Jackson. And this throw incomplete. Well, the defender all over him that time, and it's going to lead to 3rd down.
Boom, with a dime look on defense. 2 extra defensive backs on the field have covered up essentially every blade of grass. That allowed them to disrupt the play.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has them staring at a 3rd and 10. Now Jackson lets this go for Renfro downfield. It's caught inside the 25.
And he's going to be out of bounds inside the 25-yard line. It's a big play there for Vegas. 59 yards.
So barely time to catch our breath. Here's first and 10 just outside the red zone. Jackson. That's into a crowd and intercepted. And the Chargers are going to take over once again with a football at their own 20-yard line.
Well, those have been a problem for them all season, but never quite as much as they have in these last few minutes. Let's count it up now. A pair of picks on his team's last two drives and double-digit interceptions this season. I don't care if you're the best in the game or an undrafted rookie. You've got to take better care of the football or you're going to cost your team chances.
The Charger drive about to get going. As we eat closer and closer to intermission, Charles, remember last time out they punted. They would love to get points here, especially if this is going to be their final possession of the first half.
Yeah, and this is what close games feel like because the pressure.
He's got a man complete. Past the 20. And all the way in for a Charger touchdown. One play, 80 yards. Pretty easy drive to recap.
It certainly is, but not so easy to execute. Starting on your own 20, you want something to kickstart your drive and get it off to a nice start. They went for the whole thing and got it. That's a great way to send a message to the opposing team.
The kick unit on here for the Chargers as they will send this one away. Taken in at the 3. And he'll be tackled just shy of the 25. The Las Vegas offense ready to start this next drive. As the offense comes out here, Charles, remember they threw the interception last time out, but they were moving the football down the field. Looked like they were going to have a sustained drive that ended in points, but then the pick ensued.
And because of that, there's no way you can call the last drive a success. Yes, there are things to build on because they found some play calls that work. Now, they've got to build another drive and find a way to avoid the turnover the plague did on the last one.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Here's Jackson to throw. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete. A misconnection there. He's hit on just 50% of his passes thus far. That's not where you want to be.
Now you see the evolution of the game. You go back to the quarterbacks of old, 50% would be terrific because they threw the ball downfield almost every time they threw it. Now with the short passing game, you should be above 60% just to be in the average range.
Oh, he's going to let this go for the end zone. And this is going to be intercepted. Left side, 20. And he brings this one back. It's a pick six and a Charger TD. Out comes the kicking team here for the extra point. And this one's right through to make it a 14-3 ball game.
Makes the score Chargers 14, Raiders 3.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. Amir Smith-Marset now from his end zone. And he'll be out of bounds here. A yard shy of the 25 and the 24. The Raider offense set to get this drive started. They're sort of seeing themselves spiral out of control. Let's see if they can get things back on track.
And this is where the coach is walking that line of being calm and really being firm with his team. had one tell me once, you know, when we were having a tough patch, this too shall pass, this too shall pass, and it finally kept having a rough patch. He said, but you've got to do something to make it pass. And that's what they have to do. They've got to get some control back, get themselves reasserted, and calm things down.
See if they can get calm and reassert themselves here. Now Jackson on first down. And it's complete to Adams. And he will score. Touchdown, Las Vegas. Devontae Adams, his 11th touchdown of the year. And the Raiders are able to strike quickly here as they are in for six.
I think if you pulled defensive backs, they would say the corner route, take that out, make it illegal, because that is so hard to recognize and so hard to adjust, because your first move is to not get beat in the middle of the field. And that's how they move you first before they break off to the corner.
But then as the wide receiver, great job. It's tough to turn those upfield and go, but he did a great job with it there.
Really good balance, really good body control. And how about the end result? A touchdown.
Following the touchdown, ready to kick it away, is Carlson. And they'll put up the stop sign there as his guys will get it at the 25. The Charger drive about to get going.
Well, partner, you know, coaches always say that every play is designed to score a touchdown. Sometimes that's not really true, but last drive, that was the case. One play to get into the end zone, and now they'll try to duplicate that success here.
And it's rare for those moments to happen. Incredible when they do. And you saw the celebration. Pure, unbridled joy after that one.
And nothing but green grass here, middle of the field. And he takes it in for a Charger touchdown. Austin Eckler with career touchdown number 60. And the Chargers are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Extra point right down the middle. And it gives his guys a 12-point advantage.
Chargers 21, Raiders 9.
The kick unit on here for the Chargers as they will send this one away. And he'll just sit on this one as their drive will start at the 25. Offense for Las Vegas about set to begin the drive.
A strong showing their last time out. They scored the touchdown, but Charles, they look up and they're still down double digits, so you feel like just to keep pace, this drive probably needs to end in the end zone as well.
Yeah, and I think the best move for them is to not worry about how far they are down on the scoreboard, but to just remember the last drive and how it ended. Go ahead and try and repeat that. Then you can look at the scoreboard and see where this game is.
Now a nice throw here, right side. He hauls it in. Give them 12 yards that time, and a Las Vegas first.
That's definitely what we call our defense an uh-oh play. And what you mean by that is against Lamar Jackson. When you see him out of the pocket, your first thought is, uh-oh, he's going to try and run it. How do I get to him and get him on the ground? And guess what? That didn't happen, and his receivers took advantage.
Here's Jacobs, and hit behind the line. He lost the football. It's loose and picked up by the Chargers. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And he takes it back to the house. It's a fumble recovery and a Charger touchdown. Even the great ones, some of the best, they're not immune to the fumble, and here it really hurts them.
If the ball gets away from any runner's body, that's when the defense pokes at it, swipes at it, swats at it, and finds a way to create a big play for themselves.
So here's the kickoff now as he'll get it again following that fumble return for a score.
And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. The Las Vegas offense ready to start this next drive.
And Charles, we'll see what they can do here. Not a ton of time left, but enough certainly to get points out of this drive, and they need them right now because they're trailing.
Yeah, this is exactly why you practice a two-minute drill all through camp and at least one practice each week before a game. A minute left, more than enough time to string a few completions together, reach the end zone, and then make that walk back to the locker room just a little more animated.
The Raiders going to use one of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. It's been a very one-sided game so far. They got to change what they're doing right now, don't they? You can't wait till the halftime speech to make an adjustment.
No, you can't, because if you're doing it right, you're adjusting from series to series, and they need a big adjustment here to try and put some points on the board.
Off the play fake, here's Jackson. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks.
Well, these guys have definitely been outplayed in the first half. I like their countenance. I like the way that they're having panicked out there, the way they're carrying themselves. They're starting to move the ball, and what you have to do, maintain your poise and start to put together some drives.
First and 10 here. You know, if they could just get three out of this, there's something about narrowing it to a two-score game at half that makes it feel like much less of an obstacle.
They take a shot downfield there, but it winds up falling incomplete.
And not a common sight, at least on this drive. A momentary setback, though, for this passing game that has been moving well this series. Good thing for them, though. Still two more downs to connect and try and pick up another first down.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Now it's Jackson.
He'll get this underneath to Jacobs, and he'll be taken down, but not before they work this to the 45.
Now the Raiders going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 26 seconds to go until halftime. And they'll need the 39 here for a first. This is third down. Jackson will throw again. He's got a man open. It's Hunter Renfrow. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. Great way to convert on third down there. 21 yards the play.
With the kind of game he's had so far, you had to know that on third down, that they would be looking his way, and they did, for big yardage and a first down. I think the defense fell asleep at the switch on that one. I would have doubled him, tripled him, anything to keep the ball out of his hands.
And this is caught at the 8. And he will reach the 5-yard line before going out of bounds. Another big gainer that time. This one goes for 19 yards.
Just picking up yardage in bunches here these last few plays. They have moved right down the field, and just like that, they're going to be set up with a first and goal.
This is first and goal, and a golden chance to get a score back here before halftime. Jacobs going to try the middle, and he'll go backwards, losing yardage to the 5. Now the Raiders going to burn their third and final timeout as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in this first half. So they've been in the red zone 3 times, and it's yielded just 3 points. Can they find the end zone here on second and goal? The left side throw complete to Adams. Touchdown! Davante Adams in the final seconds of the first half. And the Raiders are able to cut into this lead in the final seconds of the first half. Extra point by Carlson, up and good. And they're able to cut this deficit down to 12.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away.
And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25. The Charger drive about to get going.
And with 10 seconds left, not really enough time to put something together.
Just do get the playoff as he'll look to throw. And that is incomplete. 7 seconds remaining.
Everything about that play tells you about today's NFL offenses and what they're asking out of running backs. You can't just be a guy who can run the football. You have to be able to catch it as well. And he didn't get that done on that play.
So following the incompletion here, 2nd and 10 from the 25. Now Herbert with it, looking to pass. Knocked away and incomplete.
Certainly no lack of aggressiveness here. They were hoping for the home run play to get them 6 points. They're hoping for a catch, maybe a call, but they figure they can at least get into field goal range with a completion.
Now they face a 3rd and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. This time they stay on the ground, and he'll be stopped at the 27-yard line, well short of the first down marker. So we have reached halftime intermission with the visiting Chargers on top as we are off to Orlando now to check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number 3 alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. The Raiders are going to have it first, and they trail here as we get back to it in this third quarter of action. This take it in at the goal line.
The Raiders take over first and 10 at their own 23-yard line.
Offense set to get this drive started.
This offense, Charles, had a strong first half throwing the football, at least in terms of yardage, but that hasn't translated.
And his pass is intercepted for the 4th time today. Picked off by the linebacker, Jalen Smith. And the Chargers are going to take possession of the football. And that one is going to sting. First play of the third quarter and a turnover.
And you have to know that at halftime, they spent a lot of time going through their checklist of what they wanted to accomplish to start this third quarter. Turning it over like this was not on that list.
Not at all. You come out of the locker room trailing, so that first drive to establish momentum is very key.
Crucial.
In motion right is Jones. After the turnover, here's Herbert. And that is caught on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. The throw took him a little too far at 2nd down.
That incompletion certainly slows things down a little bit and brings up a very important call for second and long. What do? Run and try and get some yardage and make it third manageable? Or challenge the coverage again, hoping for a bigger gain?
So second down and 10. Once again, they'll go from the 40. They'll send the tight end in motion left. That flag accepted, and it backs the offense up a little bit. The delay of game, they're operating behind the stick, second and 15. Herbert off of play action. He's going to look for Allen now on the deep ball. And that going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down. The turnover put him in great field position. They don't want to squander it with third down coming up.
No, not at all. And you know what else you do? You make your defense mad.
Yeah.
They got you the football, gave you a great opportunity. You got to cash in and get some points.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Herbert trying to force it to Allen, and it's intercepted,
picked off by Nate Hobbs,
and the Raiders are going to take possession of the football. So that changes things. You get the interception, and then to boot, a good return tacked on.
And really, it was down to him versus the quarterback on the return, and that's one you would think the defender would win, but a nice job there of seeing the play all to the end and making the tackle by the QB.
Play action. Now Jackson. Got a man. It's Darren Waller. And down to the 20 he'll go before heading out of bounds. 25 yards that time.
You know, when we call a game, we talk about Lamar Jackson and his speed and his elusiveness and the ability to get him on the ground, how tough that is for a defense. But how about his development as a thrower, as a professional?
Three tight ends in the ball game here on first and 10. Play action. It's Jackson. He'll buy some time right, and this is incomplete.
His back has been a dependable safety valve all game, so he went back to him when his first read was covered. Just unable to connect, so the play results in no gain.
After the incompletion, here's second and 10 from the 20. Jackson now. Got a man, and he hits him in stride. And the Raiders are going to have a first and goal coming up as the tackle made at the 3-yard line. Jacobs. And just a short gain that time as they're able to get him down. Jacobs again, and he is in. Touchdown, Raiders. Josh Jacobs hitting double digits with his 10th rushing touchdown on the year, and the Raiders have got it back to within a score. And they're going to get the two-point conversion caught in the end zone.
touchdown. Ready to kick it away is Carlson. And we'll see a return here from the end zone. And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20. The Charger drive about to get going. Still enjoying the lead here in the third quarter despite their defense giving up that last touchdown. Now they'll see if they can get the equalizer here on this drive. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. Looking downfield for Jones. On Herbert, his third interception. Picked up by Trayvon Merritt. So, my goodness, I would have thought this personal not too long ago, but that turnover there means we have a game again.
Yeah, it's been a completely different team here in the second half. I just wonder on the other side of the field, where the starters telling the backups, get ready, you're going to get some playing time. And now guess what? Hope they didn't cut the tape off of their wrists and ankles. They've got to go back out there and play.
Now he's going to swing this one out to his running back. And only able to get two here, stopped at the 30. From the 30 on second down, Jackson, and a pass complete to Waller on the out route. Calling a gain of 6 on the play, and now 2 yards to go on third down.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take what you can get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now it gives them a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
They come to the line, needing only 2 yards to gain the first here.
Hey, middle.
Third and 2, here's Jackson. Looking deep for Adams. And unable to connect, incomplete. Now give them credit, they took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down.
That's an excellent job right there on third down. Like any defense, you never want to let them get anything started. And that would have been a first down. Instead, you saw the contact on time, no penalty. And before this drive could get wings, it's fourth down.
They're going on fourth down. It's Jackson. He'll find Smith-Marset complete. Finding room at midfield. And he will go out right near the 35-yard line. They go for it on fourth down, and it pays off big time as they pick up 29.
Well, all came together on that one, didn't it?
Big time throw on fourth.
Now that had to feel good, didn't it? Taking that type of a gamble there, making it pay off. What a throw.
And tough as a receiver because no matter how perfect the pass, you know it's fourth down and you got to convert.
A little bit of extra pressure, but he overcame it.
Jackson's throw complete here to Waller. And he is out of bounds inside the 30.
Well, that's always a good place to throw it just because he's one of the biggest targets not only on his team but in the National Football League.
And you and I both know the quarterbacks love these large body tight ends, and why not? Nowadays, they're really wide receivers who are just taller and have a little bit more weight. These guys catch the football, make big plays downfield. In the old days, we wanted them to block. Now coaches want them to catch the football first.
Trying to run for it with Jacobs. And down he goes, but the stiff arm utilized effectively there. And it helps him move the sticks. They get 6 on the pickup there as the drive will continue.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
And able to get this down inside the 15, either the 13 or 14 before he's out of bounds. That's good. The completion there for 7 yards, and that's going to bring up second down. Throwing is Jackson. Throw left side complete. That's Edwards. And he's going to be taken down right at the 10-yard line. Back to the running game with Jacobs. And running room hard hard to come by here. He gets it down to the 8. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be 2nd and 8.
I have to think a major focus of the halftime meets had to be figuring out how to create space for the running game to get operating.
Well, what you pointed out to me at half seems accurate. That line has struggled to sustain blocks.
Yeah, I would agree with that totally. They've got to focus on staying on their double teams at the first level, make sure that block's secured before they slide off and try and chip someone at the second level.
Yeah, he's got it. Touchdown, Raiders. That's an old-fashioned death march there, partner. Took them a lot of plays, but hey, they did the job.
And the defense always preaches getting off the field, making a play, and turning it back over to their own offense. Unable to do so. A long, sustained drive by the offense.
Extra point by Carson, up and good. And that gives him a 3-point lead. Touchdown, ready to kick it away is Carlson. And here comes a return from a few steps into the end zone. Oh, good looking return set up here. And a good return, able to get out across the 35 to the 36. The Charger drive about to get going. They are looking to make a bit of a 180. They are sputtering right now.
And frankly, I think it's time to call your playmakers together and say, all right, guys, we're going to lean on you through this patch. We need you to get us back on track and get us going in the right direction. So you're calling plays geared to them. Not necessarily what you look at your plays. Oh, this hurts the defense. I want the ball in the hands of X, Y, and Z and see if we can move forward.
So don't get too cute. Go to the playmakers. Yards the gain on that last run. Here's 2nd and a couple. Play fake to Eckler. It's Herbert. And his pass is intercepted for the 4th time today. Picked off by Rocky Sin. And the Raiders are going to take over a couple of yards shy of midfield. But what a turnaround. They exited the lockers with a nice lead. And now all of this. What's happened?
So when you start to write your novel, you'll start out with, it was a tale of two halves, won't you?
Hey, but I'm a bad writer.
I don't know exactly what happened because sometimes teams can go in with a lead and get too comfortable, too relaxed, and a couple of things go wrong, and it's hard to get back that good feeling.
After the interception, here's Jackson. And he'll just get rid of it.
And when you've thrown as many interceptions as he has in this one, you definitely start getting a little hesitant to throw the ball out wide because that's prime pick six territory. That time, he made sure the only guy who was going to catch it was sitting in the 3rd row.
So now 2nd and 10 after the incompletion on 1st down. Counter play with Jacobs. And this has been a familiar sight all afternoon as they stop him behind the line. On 3rd down, Jackson. Open man is Edwards. He's got it. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. A well-executed 22-yard gain.
And that certainly appears to be a critical conversion right there because not only do they keep the drive going, They take valuable time off the clock as well. They have to feel really good about that last completion.
And that's complete to Adams. And they're going to be set up now with a ball at the 13-yard line.
Well, that should be a reminder defensively, and I think it's a reminder to myself because you just can't sell out to stop the run. There's still enough time that this offense can move the football through the air, even on first and second downs, and they obviously picked the right spot to throw the ball there.
From the 13 now, they work on first and 10. Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And he's brought down. So first and goal, 6 points here would go a long way toward wrapping this. And he's in. Touchdown, Raiders. Josh Jacobs, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Raiders get an important score there to extend their lead here in this fourth quarter. Extra point by Carlson, up and good. And his guys will take a 10-point lead. Following the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Carlson. They'll elect to bring it out here from the end zone. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one. The Charger drive about to get going. And the script really is flipped for them. The momentum on the other sideline, and now they have to try and battle back from a two-score deficit. Play clock down to zero, and this is not the way to start a drive. So they accept the penalty, of course, and push the offense backwards a bit. The delay of game backs them up 5, first and 15. The shotgun. Here's Herbert. The quick throw knocked away. It's incomplete. Another throw there off the mark, and obviously he's battled all of the interceptions. Things just haven't been true to form for him. I don't know. What do you think's going on out there, CD?
That's a great question, and my suspicion is he's been coached really well to not show that he's having a problem. You know, they always tell you no matter what, you keep throwing the football with confidence. Well, we're not seeing a confident thrower right now. He's off balance, the passing game's off balance, and the defense is taking advantage.
Play action this time for Justin Herbert. And this is caught, first catch for Keenan Allen. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. A gain there of 30 big ones. Big plays back and forth just continue. Both offenses excelling.
And I hear the excitement in your voice while you're calling this game. This hurts my soul as a defensive player, watching these teams go up and down the field and put points on the
board. Do me a favor the rest of the way. Sit. And down he goes. Brought down a Raider sack. That huge loss on the sack makes this job much more difficult. It's now second down and 22 yards to go. Justin Herbert looking to pass. And this one too low.
All right, help me out here a little bit, partner, because what I'm seeing is a passing game that's just struggled to complete anything. No rhythm, no timing. Seems like every pass is also contested well, so give some credit to the defense.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Nowhere to go for Herbert, and he's going to go down.
long. Nichols in there to take him down. Third and long.